Evening, friends. I know it's the last session. It's been a long day for everybody. Now, the team here, we thought we'd give you a basket of thoughts, ideas, and let it be with y'all for y'all to then ask the questions. Picking up from where Prashant and Andrew gave certain ideas and points, I'll pick up two words: global enterprise and develop. Has anybody heard of the word VUCA, VUCA world? I'm sure a lot of you must have heard, right? This word was coined way back by the US Army. That stands and that actually represents our world today. V stands for volatility, uncertainty, complexity, ambiguity. Now, these are times which are defined by the VUCA elements, the uncertain times, unpredictable times. It's very dynamic. There is nothing which is to stay. And on top of that, we're talking about a global village or a global enterprise in a global village. Now, there's nothing global. Everything is local and everything is global because that's the way we operate. So when you're looking at talent development in a global world which is more local and something which is defined as a VUCA world, and I'll take it from Prashant's input about the black swan, which basically says there are certain events which are unpredictable. That means that we do not have any earlier events to fall back on as to how to react to those situations. So it just adds a little more flavor to the VUCA world which we're already in, right? So development here becomes a challenge. So therefore, what are we looking at? What do we need to look at as an organization to grow our talent, develop our talent, to ensure that they can compete, perform, excel in our global enterprises, in the global village that we today perform in? We need to look at to be more adaptable, more enabling. That's the kind of leadership we need so that we have our talent more and more becoming ready for the world that we are in today. There is no one such program, one such developmental path that we can really say, this is it, this is what it will be, and we are sure to succeed even if we are operating locally or we are operating globally. So that's the kind of a flux and a challenge that we are in. And that's where people like Andrew, who bring in the extrinsic factor of assisting this whole developmental process, steering and spending time to bring in certain programs which are going to aid each one of our organizations, which might be playing locally, but are governed by the so-called global and local laws. That's the level of unpredictability. Now, I'm in a company called Aramex International. Does anybody know what Aramex is into? It's into logistics, supply chain, all right? So it's a global company, but when we are looking at development, we also go by the same parameters. So irrespective of whether it's a talent at the very start level, where my revenue earners are, it's majorly operational people, or it's my leadership team, what I need to provide is an agility towards proactive development and ensure that people do it more as an intrinsic factor rather than just an extrinsic factor. It has to become a DNA. It has to be value-based so that it sinks in, because nothing else is stable in this world. Today, everything is in a flux. And we are looking at the challenge of developing our talent in this kind of a world. So I wanted to leave these two words with y'all, taking the thread from where Prashant and Andrew brought in the extrinsic factor. I think I'll leave y'all with that as an add-in, and I'll pass on the basket of thoughts to my colleagues here.